Your kids will be saying,
please 5 more minutes. I can't believe I did that.
And
look how high I can bounce.
Spring Free is the world's safest trampoline, the place where stories are made. The innovative design boasts no springs, so you know you're safe. Go ahead and create the greatest stories you'll tell your friends. We're back in stock. Get it while you can. To learn more about the world's safest trampoline, visit springfreetrampoline.com.
Mom, come watch us!
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your driver's license is important so you can get back and forth to work, get your kids to school, and back and forth to daycare. If your license has been suspended because you can't pay your tickets, you can't do any of those things. Let's talk about Chapter 13 bankruptcy. You may have heard that tickets cannot be discharged, but they can be dealt with in a Chapter 13 case. Why not come in for a free consultation? The chapter you choose will make all the difference to your getting back, legally, on the road. Let's design a plan to pay off your tickets and restore your license immediately. I'm attorney Travis Gagne. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. Last summer, this old dude in Germany started chasing after a wild boar that stole his bag. And the photo of this went viral because, he was naked when this all happened.
The boar?
And the dude.
Oh, okay.
Both of them. Yeah.
That's how I keep clothes on these boars.
I just want to see a boar in clothes now.
Right. A little tuxedo. Yeah.
Oh, that's adorable.
Yeah, he was doing some nude sunbathing like people like to do near this lake called, near this lake in Berlin. And,
have you ever bathed naked? Sunbathed naked?
Oh, yeah.
You have?
Oh, remember, I've been to that nude beach in Hawaii.
BJ's been to Little Beach.
Yeah.
That's the name of it.
I know. So you laid out a towel and just laid there and took in the sun?
I walked around, took in the sun, did all. Yeah, just did what you would do at the beach, just without any clothes.
Without any clothes, okay.
Yeah.
I think I just go straight to the water. I'd just be still like, I know it's okay to be naked, but why don't I cover myself up with water?
Yeah. Oh, see, well, yeah, I mean, once you realize everybody's naked, right, then you're the weird one if you're not.
True.
So you quickly, you have one fear that flips to the other fear. It's like, I get there and I go, God, I can't believe it. If people are going to see me naked, then I don't want to take my clothes off. And then I realize I am the only weirdo with clothes on. Now I feel weird. So it's like, I was like, all right, I can't win no matter what I do. All right.
Do you apply the sunscreen before you leave your place? Or do you? Sometimes we get to the beach and then that's when I put sunscreen on my body, you know?
Oh, yeah. You want to give people a show.
Okay.
Wow.
Because I feel like that's like one of those. This was an excuse for taking care of business in public. I swear I was just putting sunscreen on it.
Oh,
just use the spray sunscreen, please, for the love of God.
I don't like that spray stuff.
You still have to rub it in.
Oh, yeah. Steve, you got to, you know, you what? You got to put the lotions on the body.
It puts the lotion on the skin.
Yeah. That's what you got to do. So, how about this guy?
So you're just doing that. You're like, I burn easily. Stop looking.
Yeah. It's a really sensitive part of my body.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, he was sunbathing nude. The wild boar takes off with his bag. I'm assuming that's where his clothes were. So he's like, I better get this bag back. And so this woman, Adele, did get a shot. She got an action shot of this guy running after the boar.
Oh, my gosh. I'm looking at the picture right now, and it's amazing.
It really is. And the picture has inspired a brand new toy that you can buy. And this company that makes model trains recreated the moment with little action figures. And they're selling them as an accessory for their train set, so you can make it part of your landscape. That would be awesome. I have to say, my dad was a train collector, and he had quite a setup downstairs in our home growing up. That would have been awesome if he had a naked dude chasing a boar on his train set. That'd be great.
My wife's grandpa is a massive train collector. Like, he has an entire shed or a garage room set up. I think I've posted the picture before, and people talked about just how, like, incredible it looks. Like, it's like out of a museum. It's amazing. And if I get this for him, I could just take him. Either A, I'd give it to him. I think he has a good enough sense of humor that he would be like, that's hilarious. Or B, I just sneak it in there.
Oh, man. Sneaking it in there would be epic because, you know, he probably is meticulous and knows everything in every place that's there.
Right, but it's so big that it'll take him a while to realize the room is so big.
Either way, I think it's a good idea. Probably, you know, if you want to be sure just to be nice, I'd give it to him because what a great gag gift that actually fits his life.
I almost want to get one for because every Christmas, like he gave us a little one of a train set that we put around our Christmas tree. And it's vintage train set. I love it. So cool, right?
Yeah, get it for your Christmas tree.
And then just sneak it on there without my wife knowing. Because it's kind of like, you know, like one of the train things has like an animal display, like a lion and a gorilla and all that.
What if
I had the wild boar on one of them and then him naked on the other train?
Totally.
Oh, I love this plan. Okay. I mean, you've got a new toy.
Where do I buy this?
Where is this? I'm looking in the story, and
I don't have any information about where to buy it.
And they just said it's a company that makes model trains. Okay,
we're worried about things being considered ads in the world of like any kind of like form of print media or social media or whatever. But this is a situation where you need to tell us.
Well, here's the problem. I don't think that it's going to be on sale for long because Adele, who took the original picture, is now trying to sue the company. She's thinking about suing the company because they recreated her picture in a train thing, which...
Oh, shut up.
I'm like, I guess, do you need permission to recreate somebody's photo in a train toy thing like that?
I could see if, like... someone took her photo, made it into a shirt, or like, you know, did a car. I this seems weird because they're really just recreating the moment, not necessarily the photo. Sure, the photo is how we found out about it, but this is the moment, not the photo.
This is tough though because it does look like he looks posed very similar to how he is in the photo as he's running, and same thing with the boar. I suppose if you could have had
it's cool, like because she's just taking a picture of him.
Well, that is another story. I mean, when you're in public, are you open game for anybody to take a picture of this? I know, you can't. I know us. We can't reuse pictures without permission. We can't post them.
He gave her permission to post the picture.
He did. Okay, perfect. So we know that she's not in violation of him, but.
But what about the boar? Did the boar say it was okay? No, we don't know.
PETA should get involved in that, Steve. I'm surprised they haven't commented.
They probably are, for all we know.
Yeah, so this guy's name hasn't been made public, so we don't know who the old dude is. We know Adele is pissed off at the train company, but we don't know the name of the train company.
Not the singer.
Who's rolling in the deep.
Yeah.
That would be funny
if it was Adele.
I did find out what the wild boar took. He ate his pizza and took his laptop bag. But he took his pizza, so I feel like that's payment enough for the picture.
Wow, you don't even put on a pair of shorts. You're just running around.
Eating pizza. What a look.
He's running around and looks like other people are clothed. So I don't know how nude this is. You know, like the place I went to, Little Beach, it was sanctioned as a nude area. He looks like he's just running around a park where there are just people just dress regularly. So I'm not sure what this is. A great story either way.
Or was he in the naked part? No. It looks like two guys are naked that are sitting there. They're shirtless.
Oh, okay.
There's other two dudes. They maybe didn't get the memo.
Oh, all right. So it's, that's a weird.
Oh, one guy looks like he has shorts on, but he's shirtless. The other guy either has really short shorts or he's just buck naked.
Yeah, you're right. It's so weird. The whole setup is where it's like, wow. Well, what kind of people don't want to get involved? Like, if it's a naked park, go naked. I mean, what are you doing at the naked park if you don't want
to?
All right.
Maybe I was like, we go to a park sometimes, and then part of the park has like an off leash area.
Oh,
so
right.
There's like an off pants area for this park.
I had thought about that. Where are you going? The off-pants area. Yeah. Oh, okay, great. Well, we'll keep you posted. And if we find out the name of this train company, we'd be more than happy to post that because we all want this as a gift, I think.
I keep finding, and it keeps coming up as the Bush Model Railway Accessories. Well,
of course it does.
But I can't find the actual thing on their site. Their site is like from like 1988. So I'm trying to find it. I can't actually find it.
I found it on eBay.
Angel Fire.
It's close to that. It's a GeoCities sort of thing, man.
I mean, we could always just buy it. There's a couple of them on eBay. So I don't know if they're...
What are they charging?
Like $16.
Oh.
Yeah, and it only goes for about 14 or 15. So it looks like there's not a big markup.
Wow. Okay, Steve, $16 is not bad.
Buying now.
Are you really buying it?
Maybe, if it's not too crazy after all the fees and stuff, because it's coming from a different country.
Atta girl.
Oh, the shipping.
Oh, Steve, you're not going to do it.
I'm not dropping $16 for this thing. It's like maybe $5.
He's out.
Wow. There's nothing that's $5 anymore. Do you know $5 is like a quarter? And like when we were growing up.
World?
Hey, can I borrow a quarter?
Maybe I'm Mercer Island, but $5 gets me a lot in Puyallup.
Yeah, in Tacoma, plenty.
What is it? What does $5 get you? A cup of coffee?
$5 meals.
Yeah. Well, okay. Yeah. But they used to be, remember those used to be dollar meals?
You get 5 coloring books at the dollar store.
All right. Well, you know what? Congratulations to you. I think this is the perfect purchase. I really do. Vicky, go ahead and do it. I authorize this. Now, it's your money, of course. That's why I authorized this.
Yeah, right.
All right. There we go. Nice. Very, very nice. I don't know if you guys saw. There's a, I don't know what the theme is today, but there's a new trailer park for swingers. All right. I don't know if any wild boars are running around, but there are swingers. And by the way, this trailer park for swingers has the best marketing slogan. I'll tell you what it is at 8:17 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Your kids will be saying,
please 5 more minutes. I can't believe I did that.
And
look how high I can bounce.
Spring Free is the world's safest trampoline, the place where stories are made. The innovative design boasts no springs, so you know you're safe. Go ahead and create the greatest stories you'll tell your friends. We're back in stock. Get it while you can. To learn more about the world's safest trampoline, visit springfreetrampoline.com.
Mom, come watch us!
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
Imagine if you could sell your home and get paid twice. With Orchard, you can. It's simple. First, Orchard makes you a cash offer on your home. If you accept it, here's your cash. Really? Then Orchard handles the rest. Painting, repairing, listing, and showing your home. And when it sells for more than Orchard paid you for it, you get to keep the profit. Learn how to get paid twice for selling your home. Visit Orchard.com. It's the new way to home.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. There's a guy in Louisiana, and he's decided to start a new business. He's opening a trailer park for swingers.
All right.
The motto is pretty awesome, I have to say. So this new swingers trailer park, the motto is, bring your house and share your spouse.
Okay, that's pretty awesome.
City folks just don't get it.
Wow. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is, it's going to be like 80 miles west of Baton Rouge. Right now, it's just an empty plot of land, but the name of the place is going to be T-Boys Swingers Trailer Park, and that's T-E-E-B-O-I apostrophe S. T-Boys?
T-Boys?
Sign
oh my
looks
gosh, the sign is up against like what looks just like a beat down area. Like, this doesn't seem like a spot where I feel like, you know what, babe? Wanna go on a little vacation in Louisiana? She's like, yeah, New Orleans? No, to T-Boys Swinger Trailer Park.
Let's do it! But look, it's an empty plot of land now, Steve, but he's going to have himself a nude pool, a nude yoga studio. He's going to have, this is awesome, a poker hall for strip poker and a key party cabana, which means you go to the cabana, drop your key in, and then, you know, somebody pulls keys and that's who you're with.
I love how BJ just freely knows the answer to that part.
Well, you know that was my neighborhood growing up, right?
I know. Yeah. I just like to give you a hard time, but I only know that because of you. Otherwise, I would have never known what a key party is.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, this is, wow. Yeah.
So is it the development? Just like, so it's like, hey, it's not like an attraction where you go there to vacation unless someone does an Airbnb. It's more of come live in our development or in our trailer park community and also be willing to share your significant other.
Yeah, I can. Yeah, I mean, it makes sense. Though a lot of these mobile homes aren't as mobile as, you know, I mean, it's going to take effort if you are in a mobile home park already to take, because I lived in a mobile home park too. So, but still, yeah, I think you're right, Steve. I think they want you to have a permanent residence. And, you know, people build these developments and they go, here are all the amenities that we have, buy our new home here, you know, come to Eastern Washington and check this out, go to Suncadia. Well, this is Nudecadia, basically.
We have an awesome selling point. We have a skate park and a pond. Oh, yeah? We have a swingers bar and a nude bingo hall.
And I love on this sign on the outside, it's it says you have to send a picture of your spouse to get approved, which T-Boy claims is, T-Boy claims it's just a joke.
Yeah, T-Boy just wants to see pictures of your wife.
But people from all over the country have already been sending pictures. And this park is set to open in May, so he's got from now until May to get the nude stuff going.
I hope Trailer Park Boys cover this in a future season.
That would be really, yeah, that's the one thing I don't think they have done, have they?
They need to leave the trailer park and go to like a neighboring trailer park that's a swingers park.
They have gone on the road before and done like, you know, so they get outside their own park and go to other places. Not exactly considered the best movies that have ever been done, but, you know, still. All right.
Well, the news reporter had to go there and report on this.
Oh, like,
What do you got to do? You got to go talk to this guy by the name of T-Boy.
Oh, and he's T-Boy.
Yeah, and he's working on a swinger trailer park.
Yeah. All right, T-Boy. Well, you know, I mean, it's an affordable way to do that lifestyle. Because I feel like there's not a lot of, you know, low-cost destinations for the swinger lifestyle.
I don't know if you can send that link to Rev, because it looks like he's being interviewed. One person said you have to listen to this guy. He's hilarious.
Oh, okay.
So maybe send Rev the interview clip, because that might be something fun to just listen to. I want to hear T-Boy in his own words explain to us why this is awesome. You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely. I agree with you. Because it is, I mean, you know, 80 miles west of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, that's got to be deep in the middle of nowhere. I mean, I feel like it's just got to be way
deep. Stop, you go to New Orleans, you have some fun in New Orleans, and then you decide to say, okay, let's veer off and go to T-Boy's.
I mean, it's. I mean, when you figure the kind of place New Orleans is, almost anything goes in New Orleans. So I guess it's not that far off as far as what maybe you'd like to go do after the fact. You know, I feel like New Orleans is a great place to go if you're a swinger anyway. Go hang out, enjoy the city, and then go to T-Boy's.
Bring your house and share your spouse.
And the greatest line
ever.
Someone
says that the amenities include an on-site STD clinic.
Well, I mean, I don't mind that, considering if I'm going to be engaging in that lifestyle, it's nice to know that they've got a place where I can get tested quick.
Well, I think that person was joking. I don't know if they actually have that.
Oh, I really wish they would have an on-site STD clinic. That would be a great idea. Sorry, buddy.
Rev, by chance, have you found T-Boy?
Yes.
Uh-oh.
And that doesn't sound right. Do we need maybe, I mean...
No. Yeah. He's the news.
He's not going to curse on the news.
Yeah, okay, it's fair just, enough. This stupid news site sucks. So let's see if this works.
Okay.
Think. Bigger than most will know. Live free and don't be scared of it. There's everybody, there's a big community of it. I think a bunch of them is not shy. The ones that are shy, hell with them. Roll with it. Good thing compared to most things.
Since putting up this sign, Oakland's gotten calls from swingers across the country.
We have got some from Pennsylvania. We have got some from Arkansas. Of course, all around Acadiana, all around Mamou, Ville Platte, Lafayette, Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Slidell. We have text messages from all over the country. It's mind-boggling.
He said they're getting so many calls, they can barely keep up with it.
Most of them call or text just to see if it's real. Just to see if somebody's going to answer, because they're going to say, oh, no, nobody's there. It's not a real number. Or they'll get on Facebook, oh, it's not a real number. I got on there and said, I'd be a fat frog's butt if it's not a real number.
Fat frog's butt.
Wow, a fat frog's butt. Okay, you know what? This guy's serious. He knew the FFB. He's serious.
So says, I'm going to buy a plot of T-Boys and make an Airbnb.
Yeah, why not?
Nicer than that Airbnb my wife got it near Disney World that one time. It's probably nicer than that.
Oh, I would, yeah, well.
That place felt like it was a swingers club because the minute you walked in, my shoes stuck to the floor.
Oh, yeah. You really got to make sure that you clean up. No doubt about it. Buy a lot of bleach.
Oh, T-Boy, I wish you nothing but the best. Maybe I'll end up on Shark Tank and I'll be like, you know, something that like Mr. Wonderful will want to invest in.
That's more of a Robert thing.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah. Robert's all in for that kind of stuff.
Robert seems a little more naughty than Mr. Wonderful.
Mr. Wonderful, he doesn't have time for that. Damn. I don't know.
He's not into the fat frogs, but...
Yeah. Barbara might be in. You never know. You never know about that Barbara.
He does sound like a charmer, that T-Boy.
Yeah. Well, listen, I almost say that word wrong. A fat frog's butt. Boy, you say that three times fast, and it's Ted versus the FCC all over.
Oh, gosh.
City folks just don't get it.
You're right.
Oh, boy. Woo. All right, well, T-Boy, congratulations to you. You know what, man? I mean, look, there are people doing some really bad stuff in the world, I don't mind T-Boy doing that. You know what? They're not hurting me. I think it's fine. Right. Yeah, that's how I look at it. We got some sad news yesterday. Ron Popeil, who I don't know. Vicky, Danny, do you know Ron Popeil? Do you know that name?
I bet they know what he is about, though.
Yeah. He is the man that basically really created the whole genre of As Seen on TV. That, I mean, really, that is the guy that I think started that whole thing where you could buy all these products
yep.
that you that no one would ever really sell, and you probably couldn't even get space on any shelf of any grocery store. And Ron Popeil says, I don't need you. I'll just go on TV. And he made a $200 million fortune doing it.
What was this company called, like Ronco?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he had the Vegematic. Mr. Microphone.
What was the Vegematic? I remember the name, but I don't remember what it did.
I feel like it was an early sort of food processor thing.
Yeah.
Or a vegetable chopper, maybe.
Yeah.
Mr. Microphone, where you could turn your radio into a speaker.
Which was really cool. You went to a certain radio frequency, right?
Like,
go to 89.6 or something like that.
And then use the speaker.
And you'd have this microphone, you'd be able to talk right through it.
It was basically it was your own little public address system. It was awesome.
I think I remember that one actually.
It was like wireless mic too, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, the Pocket Fisherman was good, which it was basically you would take a fishing pole in your pocket, I believe, and then you'd go fish anywhere.
Yeah, it was like a little thing that you could pull out. It would be a giant fisherman, but it literally just was like a little handle and almost like a little nub
that you could make, like, and you just pull it out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This guy had some funny stuff, man.
Yeah, he died yesterday at 86 years old. Sorry, man.
I didn't even know he was still with us.
Yeah. Well,
I get him and Billy like Mays and like all those other like I seen on TV guys confused. I didn't realize the OG was still with us.
Yeah, he passed away suddenly and peacefully after a medical emergency. He was the they say he basically invented the infomercial. The Chop-O-Matic, he started back in 1959 with the Chop-O-Matic.
I remember wanting these things as a kid because the infomercials made them look so awesome.
Oh, yeah.
But, like, when do I, as an 11-year-old, need to chop something? You know what I mean? Like, it was just like, I need this. Mom, can we get this? She's like, no, I don't need this. I can do my own cutting. And I'm like, but look at it. It's on TV, you know?
He's the guy that basically started the whole phrase, but wait, there's more.
Oh, because they incentive to buy stuff.
Yeah, they credit that to him as well. So As Seen on TV, but wait, there's more. That's all Ron Popeil. And you know, man, I mean, there was no internet, but he basically did what a lot of people are doing today. They're just going around the normal distribution systems in order to make themselves famous. And that's what he did without an internet. He just did it through the infomercial.
He had the rotisserie chicken thing.
Yep.
I have a really dumb question. Did you guys have a favorite infomercial to watch? Like when it came on, you actually sat and watched the entire
thing? Girls Gone Wild one.
Okay, that doesn't count.
I mean, it was informational.
That,
you're asking a room full of guys, Vicky. I think that's going to be everybody's answer.
That was adult content for me when I was, college.
Yes.
You know what I mean? I didn't have adult films or access to anything, but you knew at around midnight, if you just start surfing the channels, eventually you will come across, what was it, Ron Francis? No, that's RGM.
Yeah. Well, Ron Francis, you know, I mean, look, he's led many lives.
Was he the Girls Gone Wild guy, and now he's gone wild with goalies?
Goalies gone wild,
Joe. Everybody.
Wasn't his name Joe something?
Joe Francis.
Yeah, it was Joe Francis. Francis.
Yeah.
Yeah. You were close,
It's Ron's sister, husband.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
Sister husband, sure.
That took his wife's name. Making all this up, clearly. I used to watch that all the time. That was my infomercial.
That was one of those things where it was like, because I didn't really stay up like often when I was like in middle school, mm-hmm. but like there would be like times where I'd be like, it's past 11. It's time for the Girls Gone Wild commercials.
It's like infomercials. After dark.
Yeah.
But on like the PG side, probably like the Ginzu knife.
Where
slice a tomato can and then with effortlessly cut open a tomato.
Mine was always the slap chop.
That was cool.
The slap chopper, the ShamWow.
ShamWow was pretty fast.
Crazy. He was awesome. He's in jail now.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
So is Joe Francis, I think.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
And Ron Popeil never went to jail. I think that's the thing to put out. There's a lot of people who have been on infomercials, either A, have just self-destructed because of their political viewpoints, or B, have gone to jail.
He's a man of integrity, BJ.
Yeah. Ron Popeil, no. You know what? He always ran on an above-board situation, as far as I know.
So, Vicky, which one was yours, since you're asking?
I would yell for my brother. We would both watch the Magic Bullet commercial, and it was like this weird swinger sleepover, it felt like, because it's like everyone's waking up hungover the next day and be like, oh, we're going to make breakfast. Check out our Magic Bullet.
Someone just texted my favorite favorite infomercial was the early 2000s Magic Bullet.
And they're like, check out all the cool stuff we can do. And I swear to God, like, who spends the night at somebody's house? Like, that many grown adults. So it has to be some sort of swingers party from the night before. They're just having breakfast now.
Oh, wow. I didn't know
really
you told
into it. Yeah,
I didn't know you had a whole backstory for what's going on. Okay. I remember the Magic Bullet.
So, what you're saying is it was the Girls Gone Wild infomercial, and then the next day they woke up and needed breakfast.
Pretty much.
No, fair enough.
Here's your smoothie. Here's your pancakes.
That's a Vitamix is pretty much what he made. They made the first Vitamix.
But they've gotten so popular, you see them everywhere now.
Yeah, Magic Bullets are everywhere.
I always did find that one funny because it was always like the adult party. And like then they had like the girl who comes out with like a hoarse voice and is like, oh, I just can't with last night. What do you got for me? And they're like, we're making you an omelet.
Here you go. Super simple.
You know what I also love about the Girls Gone Wild video, the infomercials? What's that? It seemed like all they had to do is give those girls a t-shirt and they were willing just to show their hoots.
Yes. It gave me the unrealistic expectations for my college years because that didn't happen.
Right, I had a whole drawer of t-shirts. Zero hoots scene.
Yeah. I feel like you need a special t-shirt, right? Don't you? And a camera?
A camera helped.
Yeah, the camera would have been helpful.
And they would like show a lot.
Yes.
Like close to full-on nudity.
Yes.
I mean, these girls, and they were like making out. It was awesome. One person says, Steve, you watched the whole thing. I don't even able to last a couple of minutes watching that.
Excuse me. That's why they were only a couple minutes long.
Yeah.
And I will say that when I got older.
Vicky's watching it for the first time.
I think I remember after I had my appendix taken out when I was 16, I was still awake at midnight, and this was like the only thing on the hospital television.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah. Oh, Girls Gone Wild. Woohoo! Oh, yeah. They're just like, here you go. Here's everything. I know. Those videos were just nuts.
That is like quintessential 90s.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh, yeah. Memories right there.
Hey, props to the film editor who get those censored bars in very interesting places.
Yeah they could.
Yeah.
I was finding
some bigger censored signs than others.
Yeah.
When I turned 18 and actually was able to rent the like actual DVD of it, I remember being so disappointed, being like, okay.
They did a good job of making it seem like what you were going to get is like a full-on like porn.
Yeah.
Because I think I definitely ordered one.
Yeah.
And it was like, it was just the infomercial, basically, but with nudity.
Yeah.
Well, so there was nudity. So you at least got to see how they were going wild behind the censored.
I was expecting them to get a little wilder. You know what I mean?
You're expecting the full enchilada, and you're just kind of like, I paid $44 for this. What did I do?
Well, they created a lot of thumbnails, though, because they have those. They started showing up on the porn sites, though. They're like with an extension of that. You would just watch Girls Gone Wild, and then, you know, nowadays you go to the porn site and see the after party, which is what you were looking for, Danny.
Another good texter about infomercials, the Flex Seal guy. The screen door is a boat bottom, take my money.
Yes!
That is such a good one.
Yeah.
And I didn't know this. Someone said Weird Al did a song about Ron Popeil.
Oh, that's funny.
Did he?
Yeah, apparently so.
Wow, I don't remember that either. I bet I will if I hear it, but boy.
Literally called Mr. Popeil.
Wow, I don't remember that.
Do you have it so we can hear? Like maybe I'm sure Weird Al didn't curse. I mean, I don't know. Like Mr. Popeil, mother effer.
Mr. I wonder what he sang it to.
Yeah, here we go.
I need a Ventromatic. I need a pocket fisherman. I need a handy appliance that'll scramble an egg while it's still inside its shell.
Operators of Fantify, how does that make you feel?
Help me, Mr. Popeil.
Oh, this is like
Devo.
Rock Lobster.
Or B-52s.
Oh,
yeah. That's what I was thinking of, yeah. So this is Rock Lobster.
Style parody of the B-52's Rock Lobster, and then There's a Moon in the Sky Called the Moon, Private Idaho.
Yeah, because not all of his songs are straight up parodies. Like sometimes he would just be inspired by something, and sometimes he would just write a song that really didn't have, it wasn't ripping off anybody else's music.
Yeah.
I mean, those weren't the hits for him.
Yeah, it kind of doesn't sound like, I mean, exactly like Rock Lobster, but I was thinking B-52s just because he sings like that Fred dude.
Yeah.
Sings, yeah.
See, I got a Devo vibe from the music part.
Yeah, I can see that.
I like how Rex still has a goal.
Right.
Mr. Popeil.
It's a pretty good jam.
He does a good job. He does big as a whale. He does have that sound to him.
This is why it reminds me I don't need to listen to Weird Al ever again.
Wow.
You watch your mouth. We're going to get a lot of angry texters now.
That's fine.
I learned
you can
my
all
lesson.
Hate me. I
wow, he is a treasure. Wow, Danny, when did you become a communist?
You need to see him live.
Even cut a 10-10 with it.
He's actually pretty awesome.
How are you going to convince someone to see somebody they hate live?
I'm going to tell them that we're going to see Fall Out Boy.
Oh, that's nice. And then we show up
and it's Weird Al. He's going to be walking through. He's like, why do they have all these Weird Al shirts? I'm like, oh, they're parodies. It's Fall Out Boy's new thing. They're like pretending to be Weird Al.
Oh, that's their new thing.
Yeah. They're opening for Fall Out Boy.
Thighmaster infomercials. Those were good.
Those were the great.
Suzanne Summers?
Yeah, baby.
That's all.
Yeah. Someone said working security at Studio 7 for the Girls Gone Wild tour was interesting.
Oh, gosh. There was a tour?
I didn't even know that.
Interesting is a code word for probably amazing. I would think.
That must have been just pure on bonkers. Or nuts, if you know what I mean. Because I remember when Snoop Dogg was the host or a guest host of Girls Gone Wild?
Nope.
Barely. Yes.
I did not know that was the case.
That must have been an easy sell. Hey, Snoop, you want to come get stoned and hang out with hot chicks that want to take off their tops for in exchange for t-shirts?
Yes.
Faux shizzle.
Yeah, I think that's exactly how that negotiation went down.
Girls Gone Wild, doggy style.
Yeah, I do remember
that,
actually.
That's what it was called, BJ.
Okay, well, not sure what it's about.
No, it's uncensored.
Okay. Yesterday, Steve, he did get this one wrong. Nice.
Who directed Robin Hood Men in Tights?
Oh, Mel Blanc.
No.
Steven Spielberg.
No.
Homer.
No.
That's right. Marge Simpson helped me out.
Yeah, and she keeps thinking that Mel Brooks and Mel Blanc are the same person, and they are not. Oh, yeah. Mel Brooks was the answer, not Mel Blanc. You want a shot at beating Steve? You got it. 206-421-ROCK. We're going to play Beat Migs, and we'll do that at 850 on The Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. How do I figure out who my creditors are?
People a lot of times have had a long time of not having good credit and having collections, and so they're concerned that... you may be concerned that you won't be able to find all your creditors if you file bankruptcy. How will I know which collection agency has my credit card bill from 10 years ago now? And that's something that's hard to keep track of because credit collection agencies transfer your debts all over the place. But we will pull all your credit bureaus, and by getting all three of your credit bureaus, we'll be able to tell who has your credit and debt now, which collection agencies have had it in the past, and we'll make sure that we file all your creditors when we file your bankruptcy so that nothing slips through the cracks.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.
Want to create a lifetime of memories this spring? Do you remember the joy of jumping as a child? If only there was a way your own kids could experience that same joy safely. Spring Free Trampoline has been engineered to eliminate 90% of product-related injuries. The Spring Free design boasts no springs and a flexible enclosure and proudly offers a 10-year warranty. That's peace of mind. Lock in your ultimate backyard safe space before summer arrives. Visit springfreetrampoline.com.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
Are you thinking about selling your home? With Orchard, you can skip the hassles of listing a home and go straight to getting an all-cash offer. It's simple. Once Orchard determines your home value, they make you a cash offer. Then, when Orchard sells your home for more than they paid you for it, you keep all of the profit. Maximize your earnings and minimize the stress of selling your home. Visit Orchard.com to see how you can get an all-cash offer. Orchard. It's the new way to home.